we know what high inflation is doing to our budgets, right? But what could inflation be doing to the rules for retirement planning? Plus, could Social Security recipients be in for another big increase this year? That's what we're going to talk about today on What Your Money Would Say with Andrew McNair. So glad to have you along here. Andrew and his team have offices in Pensacola and Daphne, Alabama, and it's their goal to help you retire with confidence. Let me give you the phone number so you can have this handy throughout our show. 800-848-8768. 800-848-8768. You may call this number for a complimentary visit, a discovery visit. Maybe you don't want to go into the office. Okay, you can call for a 15-minute phone call, that too. All right, all complimentary. Find us online at swan-capital.com. That's swan-capital.com. And hello to you, Andrew.
Hey, I'm so excited to talk about pay raises today. Oh. I think everyone's going to be happy to hear about that.
Who doesn't want a raise, right? Who doesn't want more money in their pockets? Okay, I got to start off, though, with this interesting story I found about scientists saying that humans could live up to 150 years. And, Andrew, what they're doing, they're exploring ways to rejuvenate our cells, okay, and have them regenerate longer. So here's the deal. They've actually tested it, and it worked in elderly mice. They did an anti-aging experiment, and they restored the vision of elderly mice.
Wow.
Isn't that cool?
That's exciting. I wonder what that does to some wrinkles. That's exciting.
Well, see, I was thinking that too. I'm like, rejuvenate my cell, you know, the cells in our face. What about gray hair? No more gray hair. And hearing, you know, I have tinnitus. Maybe that would finally go away. And plus,
that would be pretty nice. I'd have hair again.
Yeah, have hair again. And then, you know, we'd live to the ripe old age of 150. And Whoa. Now my question to you is, how long do you plan out your retirements right now?
I'd have to redo some of our retirement plans because I only have people go until 120.
See? Oh, 120? Oh, yeah. Okay. So can you imagine having a 75-year retirement?
Wow.
I think things would probably change. If we were rejuvenated,
we'd be working a lot longer.
Yeah, we'd be working longer. But anyway, I thought that was kind of cool that it actually worked. So, hey, you know, good news for anybody that has vision issues for sure. All right, let's get into something I wanted to bring up right now. And this is Bill Bingen. He was the financial advisor who developed the 4% rule back in the 90s. And so that concept 30 years ago, the 4% rule was great. But now he's saying, with this 8.5% inflation and the high market valuations, things maybe need to remain a little more conservative with retirees. So what's your approach and what's your comment on this?
Well, Louann, like the retired financial advisor that created the rule of thumb, sometimes rules of thumb need to be retired, and they need to become extinct rules of thumb. So Mr. Bingen's rule of thumb was to spend 4% in the first year of your retirement, then adjusting it annually to keep pace with inflation. Well, if you take that approach to today, where inflation's 8%, that means 12% annually. Taking that out, well, that would deplete your retirement very quickly. And that's why even Bill said himself, the problem is there's no precedent for a time like today.
Yeah.
These conditions are different, where interest rates are very low. They're not 6% like when he invented the rule. They're 1% or less, but inflation is through the roof. And so that's why, again, there's not a precedent for a situation like this.
Right. I got to throw this in there too. He retired in 2013, financial advisor, but he's living a very simple retirement. He's not eating out as much at restaurants. He doesn't go places. He just plays cards and bridge, which is fine for most people, I guess, if that's what you want to do. But also, I'm like, man, he didn't plan it right.
Well, hey, I'm not here to judge, but you're right. Bridge is not a very expensive hobby. So, yes.
Anyway, yeah. So I guess rules of thumb, any generic rules of thumb. Do you use any of those in your own retirement strategies?
Well, Louann, it's like a pilot using a compass. You know, they're good to have, but if you're trying to land in the same state, a compass will work. But if you want to land at the exact airport you planned on landing at, you need an electronic flight plan. You can't leave it up to a compass.
That's a good point. Very, very good point. Okay, so you kind of just use it as a, maybe start with, okay,
sure.
If you were just talking to somebody, yeah, you might ballpark it and go, well, let's just look at, you know, what you have and if your, you know, your assets would last and all of that. But I want you to tell us about your Swan Sleep study, because this is exactly what we're talking about. You look at income for any new person that comes in and come up with strategies to help them stretch their money so it will last throughout their retirement, even if it is 150 years.
Yeah, it's the equivalent of arriving at the exact airport versus the state analogy, is when you have a customized financial advice and knowing that you have a 99% probability of not running out of money to your 120th birthday, that's the difference between the exact airport and arriving in the same state that we hope to. That's the difference. And so when we do a sleep study for a family, what we're doing is we're looking at the main aspects of a retirement and financial plan, which consists of an income plan, like we've been talking about, a tax plan. Do we have a tax strategy? How are we shifting from taxable and qualified accounts like IRAs and 401ks to tax-free investments like HSAs and Roth IRAs? How are we making sure that we're protecting our assets from lawsuits and creditors? No one wants to be sued. Or how do we make sure that our spouse is not going to run out of money if we go into a nursing home? All of that's covered in our Swan Sleep Study. Because when I started Swan Capital, I felt like it was all of our retirees' goals to sleep well at night. It's my goal for every client that's retiring to sleep well at night. And that's why we call it a sleep study. So if you want to make sure that you have straight A's going into retirement, give us a call at 1-800-848-8768. That's 1-800-848-8768 to take us up on that 1 hour complimentary visit that we call our sleep study.
And their website, swan-capital.com. Great website there. Great information, a monthly market recap, a blog post that Andrew actually writes, the Swan blog. So some great information there. Make sure you check that out too, swan-capital.com. And we thank you so much for joining us. This is What Your Money Would Say with Andrew McNair. And they want to help you discover, what is your money saying to you? Is it going to last as long as your retirement? I'm Louann Fulmer. All right, I want to ask you about Social Security now, because I brought that up. There might be an increase next year. Of course, with this high inflation, the Senior Citizens League says that the annual cost of living adjustment, and that's what you call COLA, for Social Security could be as high as 8.9%, and that's based on our just this past March inflation
wow.
data. So if that would happen, it would be the highest since 1981. And then recipients got an 11.2% increase in benefits. So I want to talk about that for just a little bit.
Yeah, Louann, it's not something to be cheerful about, though. It's a canary in a coal mine. If you have lazy money sitting on the sidelines making 0.7%, but you're too worried to invest in the stock market or the real estate market, you are losing the war against inflation. So by just hoping that Social Security raises its income in retirement is not something to be excited about. It's really sharing with you and the public that inflation is taking the toll on everyone's purchasing power. And if you have money that is making 1% or less or 3% or less, you're not keeping pace with inflation currently.
Wow. Okay. And then, and the other thing I think of is, you know, we saw the increase of Social Security in 2021, and then Medicare costs went up.
Exactly. It washed away some of those increases.
Yeah. So that's a bummer. All right. But let's talk about claiming Social Security benefits and remind us, what are some things we need to consider before we actually start?
Well, I think if you have a pen and paper, this is some of the factors you need to write down, because when you Google on Social Security, like, when should I take Social Security, and you press I'm feeling lucky button on Google, you're going to hear 4 million different opinions on when to take Social Security. But you have to ask these questions that are personal to you. The first one is when will I stop working? If you take Social Security early, you potentially face penalties, increased taxes. Number two, do you have debts at high interests? Maybe you do need to take Social Security early because you have a lot of debt that is at 18% interest. Well, maybe we need to take Social Security early for you. Let me ask you about your health. How healthy are you? How old were your parents when they passed away? Did you live a different lifestyle than your parents? Next, age difference between you and your spouse. I think that's an important question. You might be fine in retirement, but what about your co-pilot? Are they going to have enough income to do everything they want in retirement? And then the last one, Louann, and this is where Joe at the water cooler is trying to be thoughtful and give you advice, but they're leading you astray because they don't know your performance of your retirement accounts, and they don't know the size of your retirement accounts. And so maybe they have no assets and they have to take Social Security early. So they're trying to get you to take it early and join that club versus you may have enough assets where you're only making 0.7% or 1% in the stable value fund in your 401k where you could utilize that to actually make more money on your Social Security benefits.
All right. So tell us how Social Security fits into your overall retirement income plan.
Well, exactly what I was mentioning. If you have money in your 401k that's in bonds, that's actually losing money right now, or if you have money that's in the stable value fund making 1% or 2%, but you have Social Security that's keeping pace with inflation because it has a CPI attached to it. Now, CPI, the Consumer Price Index, is not perfect. Again, inflation might be 9% and Social Security only increases 6%, but at least your income that's going to last your lifetime is increasing at 6% while your money is potentially only increasing at 1% or 2%. So this is where we sit down with a family and create an income plan, Louann, where we're bridging this time where they're deferring Social Security so that we're projecting a higher Social Security, higher pensions, but we have to create a bridge between the time they retire and the time they take Social Security. And that's what retirement savings are sometimes best utilized for.
So today, Andrew, you're offering a chance for our listeners to come in and take part in this SWAN study that you do for them. Tell them about that.
Certainly. So let me walk you through the math. After a 5.9% cost of living adjustment, the average Social Security benefit is now $1,657, so $1,600 a month. If you do the math, that adds up to $600,000 over a 30-year period. For a couple, it could be as much as $1 million. So we're talking about a $1 million asset, and this is not something that you Google and press, I'm feeling lucky. When we sit down with a family, we go through their income plan and say, what is that income plan to make sure that you have the maximum inflation-protected income in retirement? And sadly, Louann, as you know, many families, they don't have an income plan. And so that's one aspect of our sleep study. When we sit down with you for 1 hour complimentary, we're going to show you our methodology of giving you three separate and distinct buckets that you can pull income from, and you don't have to worry about market volatility for the first 5 to 10 years of your retirement because we've mapped out your income plan for retirement. So if you want to learn more about our sleep study, this complimentary visit to make sure that you're retirement ready, give us a call at 1-800-848-8768. That's 1-800-848-8768.
You're listening to What Your Money Would Say with Andrew McNair. I'm Louann Fulmer. Andrew is president. He's CEO of Swan Capital right here on the Gulf Coast. All right. I don't know if you know this guy or not, but he's a blogger, and his name is the Financial Samurai, Andrew. Have you ever heard of him?
I have not.
Okay. Well,
I'm sure he's a great guy.
Well, I'm sure he's a great guy. Yeah. But anyway, he laid out some really stark numbers about retirement. And he said that when you're planning on how much to save for retirement, you need to multiply your annual expenses by 200. So, okay, let's say you need $40,000 a year. You do the math, and that comes out to $8 million in retirement. Now, that's crazy. Who needs to aim that high? Goodness.
Well, everyone's telling you that you need $2 million or $8 million. I'm telling you that that's not exact enough. You can't settle for rules of thumbs. I like different formulas here and there to give you a rule of thumb to make sure you're in the ballpark. But at the end of the day, that's not going to cut it when you have to answer to your spouse and say, hey, sorry, we ran out of money. Or, no, honey, we got to put your retirement on pause because I didn't plan enough. That's not a good enough answer. My rule of thumb was too short.
Yeah, not good, not good. So I guess the logic behind this blog post from the financial samurai that he calls himself is the 0.5% rule. Should we only plan to take out a 0.5% from our retirement accounts? Gosh.
No, this is why people should take advice from professionals that are licensed, not just anyone that sticks a gi on and has a YouTube show is necessarily credible or not. So with a very diversified investment methodology combining real estate income, equities, and their dividends, fixed investments, there's no reason why you can't produce a 5% or more for income safely, even during these low interest rate periods.
So, Andrew, you've told us before, what do you think of some of these rules of thumb, like the 4% rule?
Louann, taglines, rules of thumb, it's just like dieting. You know, you hear these things like, never eat any carbs, don't any white foods. We have to be a lot more scientific than that. For example, to build our dividend portfolio, for example, we have to have the right mix of different income sources. So we start with preferred shares because they produce preferred dividends, which are unique. We have real estate income, international real estate income, dividend paying companies that pay out dividends, international dividends. We look at oil and energy income and bond income to come up with just our dividend portfolio. We can't just sum up everything with a rule of thumb saying you can take 0.5%, you can take 4%. We need to have an income plan that utilizes multiple different income sources to make sure that you're not liable to the market volatility that's out there or the interest rate sensitivity that's out there.
Yeah, okay. And then, you know, interest rates, double-edged sword in the world of finances because they're helpful for borrowers, but MarketWatch says that low interest rates mean it's going to take more purchasing power, you know, for your standard of living in retirement. We know that. We talk about that a lot. How do you help retirees plan around any interest rates, you know, no matter what they are in retirement?
Yeah, Louann, I'm experiencing this right now. A lot of investors are encouraged by increasing interest rates. They think it's a good thing that interest rates are going up because of inflation. And this is a great Gulf Coast analogy. That'd be like a crawdad being excited about the water temperature increasing because he's in a boiling pot. That's not a good idea to be excited about increasing interest rates because of inflation. If inflation continues to push up interest rates, that's meaning that you're not winning the war against inflation on the long term.
Real quick, I gotta ask you, this has nothing to do with interest rates. Do you eat crawdads? Have you had those?
I do. I mean, I think it's more of this communal experience of eating
it?
With friends and family. But I will tell you, it's a lot of work for a little bit
yes.
of meat.
It's teeny tiny. I've seen people do
teeny
it. I'm
tiny.
Like, okay, no, I wouldn't do that. I will eat a crab leg. Okay, that's at least you get something out of that.
Yeah. But it is a thing, though.
Little crawdad.
I was just saying, it's a thing in the South. So, I mean, I just missed a one. But they put onions in there and corn in there, and it's a really cool experience.
Yeah.
And they pour it out over the table.
Yes.
And it's really cool.
That does sound fun. It really. I've done that with crab legs before, and it was really, really fun. But it just reminds me of Chevy Chase in Christmas Vacation. When he's eating the chicken. I mean, the turkey.
Exactly. That's exactly what it is. You're like, every time.
Just teeny tiny little meat. But anyway, okay, moving on. So seriously, Andrew, let's get to why we are here on the air every weekend. You are inviting our radio listeners to give you a call, come in and see you about their questions regarding retirement.
Absolutely, to make sure that you're retirement ready. And how we do that is we call it our retirement report card, or our sleep study, to make sure that families have straight A's going into retirement. And one of the sections on the sleep study is cash reserves. And many times I've given people a C, and they say, what do you mean, Andrew? Why did I get a C? I have over $1.2 million in assets. I've done a great job saving. And I said, well, you got a C in cash reserves because you have too much liquidity. Remember that liquidity either makes you money or loses you money. And after you have a really healthy emergency savings, then we need to make sure that your money is working for you, that you don't have lazy, idle money sitting on the couch. We need to have all of your money working so that you have a fighting chance against inflation. If inflation is going to be 8 to 9% for the foreseeable future, we need to make sure that you have a fighting chance with your money earning more than 1%, ideally more than 3%. So when you come in for our sleep study, we're going to spend 1 hour answering the questions that you have about retirement. But we're going to make sure that you have straight A's going out into retirement. And we'll show you the B's and the C's that you need to convert to A's so that you're retirement ready. So give us a call at 1-800-848-8768. That phone number again is 1-800-848-8768 to schedule that sleep study today.
And let me guide you to the website, too. Great information on their website, swan-capital.com, swan with a little dash, hyphen, capital.com. And Andrew and his team, you will see, they work with families just like you. They create those swan plans, the plan with the goal of helping you sleep well at night. I mean, just imagine the anxiety relief that you could feel after you see your retirement planned out for the next 30 years. That's what the show is all about. They're offering to guide you in retirement. You shouldn't go it alone. There's too much, too many things at stake if you make a mistake with your retirement assets. So anyway, thank you so much for joining us. This is What Your Money Would Say with Andrew McNair. I'm Louann Fulmer. All right. So, yeah, we've been talking about interest rates right now, and things are, you know, changing a little bit than in past years. Inflation, definitely an issue right now. So I want to talk about options for baby boomers, maybe where they can put their retirement money in place and not have it all at risk in the market.
There are no magical investments. We know from history that there are two performing asset classes that do really well with inflation. The first is obviously equities. When you own quality companies, they are able to pass the price of inflation and the cost of inflation down to the end consumer. And the next is real estate, which can pass inflation down to the renter, the person that's the tenant. And so you don't want to settle for being the end consumer of inflation. Be a profiter of inflation. And sadly, vote for change if you're not happy with this inflation. But that's the best we can do, is take this into our own hands. Now, the market, with the stock market and the real estate market, are at all-time highs. So that's why you need someone like a professional to help you navigate these changing tides and the volatility that we're going to continue to experience in the stock market.
So there was a CNBC survey that says 42% of Americans don't actively monitor their investments to see that they are diversified like they should be. That's almost half of us. So how do you help someone get to the bottom? Because this is what you do. You can show them what's going on with their portfolio and what they should be doing to help reduce risk of large market losses.
Well, there's such a misconception about diversification, Louann. A prime example is I had someone recently come in and say, Andrew, I am actually really diversified. I have money in the S&P 500. The S&P 500 is made up of 500 stocks. I said, you're exactly right, but you're not as diversified as you might think. And their eyebrow raised. And I said, let me show you. I said, the S&P 500 is made up of 500 large U.S. companies, and it's weighted towards the companies that make the most, i.e. like Facebook and Google and Amazon and Microsoft. It's not as diversified as many people think. And the same thing happens in portfolios all the time, Louann, where someone might own a Franklin Templeton fund and they might own a Vanguard fund, and they're buying and selling the same stock because they have those accounts separately owned, but they're buying and selling the same stock, or their spouse is using another money manager while the other spouse is managing their own. So we want to integrate large company stock, medium-sized companies, small companies, multiple different sectors. I just recently met with an individual that had $2 million and 37% of their portfolio is in technology. I said, if we have another dot-com crash, you're going to really feel it. If you have 37% in financial companies and we have another 2008, you're really going to feel it. We need to have diversification, and that doesn't mean settling for the S&P 500. So one of the things that we schedule complimentary for families is what we call our sleep study. And one section of our sleep study is portfolio positioning. And we want to make sure that you're prepared for any market cycle. As I always like to say, good investors make money when the market goes up, but great investors make money either way. And you want to be a great investor. So to make sure that you're retirement ready, that you have straight A's going into retirement, give us a call at 1-800-848-8768. That's 1-800-848-8768. 6'8".
Will you need a rocking chair in retirement, or do you plan to work? That's what we're going to talk about next with Andrew. Stick around for more of What Your Money Would Say with Andrew McNair. Hi, you're listening to What Your Money Would Say. I'm Louann Fulmer with Andrew McNair, who is president and CEO at Swan Capital.
I don't need your rocking chair, your Geritol or your Medicare.
All right.
That's great.
Country music legend. Yeah, George Jones. I don't know, pretty accurate description of how a lot of people view retirement, right? They're like, no, I'm not retiring. Listen to this survey, Andrew. 59%, so about 60% of baby boomers who are still working say they expect to keep working in retirement. They want to stay active, engaged, and remain employed, even in retirement. So for your clients who want to keep working, what's the reason behind keeping that job in retirement?
Well, I think many clients have a piece of their identity in what they do. I mean, when you go to a party, people ask you, what do you do for a living? So it is a sense of your identity. Also, I think who you work with, I mean, they become part of your work family at the workplace, obviously. And we need a sense of purpose. So if you just retire, you might die if you don't have any purpose. And so I think a lot of people believe that, and they've seen that maybe play out. And so I think it is very important that you retire to something. Something that sustains your purpose, like spending time with grandchildren, traveling, staying active, and spending more time with your spouse, too.
Yeah.
All of those can continue to sustain your purpose.
Okay, so again, about 60% of us say we want to keep working. And I want to talk about how that impacts things like Social Security and Medicare benefits.
Well, it really does make a difference. I mean, if you take it early, it can really be a waste. Some families unknowingly take Social Security at 62 and are surprised that they have an income limit of $19,560, and they have to pay back some of their Social Security, and they say, what gives with that? Why did I turn that on too early? And then the second thing is they take retirement or Social Security at full retirement, and they're surprised yet again when they get the tax bill on April 15th because they forgot that Social Security is up to 80% taxable. And it's really a surprise that the government hands you a check, then asks for it back.
Yeah, that's crazy. So, yeah, that's interesting. I was thinking because, you know, I can still work when I'm full age retirement and then start collecting Social Security. I'm like, that's awesome. But I forgot about the taxes. Then I'm going to be taxed 80%. Oh, my. Okay. So that's interesting. And that's why you need guidance on, you know, claiming Social Security. You could also, wait till the full retirement age,
the max.
The max,
absolutely.
Yeah. 70, at age 70. So for those people who do keep working in retirement, are their taxes going to be less in retirement overall? Or what have you seen?
Well, the IRS doesn't give a senior discount. They tax everyone, even retirees. I mean, the difference is when you're retired, you can't change or manipulate your income. You can't shut off incomes like valves. The RMD, Social Security, and pensions, they're coming. So you're at really the mercy of whoever is in political office at the time of your golden age of retirement, which really takes you out of the control. It takes and puts politicians in control, whoever dictate what the tax law is during your retirement.
Darn it. I'm sitting here going, they better be good to us. We've worked a long time, you know. But oh my gosh. Okay, so this is very complicated. I feel very complicated. And you help people come up with tax strategies for retirement. And that's all part of your retirement planning. Tell us about that.
Absolutely. You know, I think many families are really confused. They think they are doing tax planning. They go to a CPA who helps them file their taxes, last year's taxes. And so they're always looking in the rear view at last year's taxes. And what we help families do is we work alongside their CPA, their tax attorney, in starting to actually have conversations about the tax future and looking through the windshield towards the retirement, looking through the future and saying, how do we start shifting your tax responsibility and liability to more tax-free investments, so you don't have to worry about who's in political office for the next 20 years of your retirement. And so I think it is more important than ever, because right now, the national debt percentage to GDP is equivalent to what it was in World War II. So it can't be much of a better time than right now. And if you're listening, you say, Andrew, I am concerned about my taxes and retirement. Give us a call at 1-800-848-8768, because when we sit down with you for your complimentary 1 hour sleep study, we're going to make sure that you do have a tax strategy of shifting some of your qualified and taxable accounts to tax-free accounts. And so it's a great time to continue to do that while taxes are still on sale up until 2025. So give us a call at 1-800-848-8768.
And I want to guide you also to the website. It's swan-capital.com, swan-capital.com. And you can see there that Swan Capital will guide you with your, with tax strategies in retirement. They want to help you keep more of your hard-earned money in your pockets, because, you know, we need to know what impact will the withdrawals that we take, the investments we make, have on our taxes in retirement. Get some guidance on that and give them a call. That number again, 800-848-8768, for a complimentary visit. Or it could be a phone call too. 15-minute phone call, complimentary. And we thank you so much for joining us. This is What Your Money Would Say with Andrew McNair. I'm Louann Fulmer. So it turns out that one of the biggest expenses in retirement that we're going to pay is taxes. That's what we're talking about right now. So, Andrew, is this something we need to save for, or do you use strategies?
Absolutely. I think you have to do both. Right now, America has billions of dollars sitting in cash and cash equivalents, which are making very little. But worse yet, whatever they do earn, you're getting taxed and potentially paying taxes once again, because you already paid taxes when you made the money that you put into your money market. So what can you do? We work with many clients that are 5 years out from retirement or 3 years out from retirement, and we help them do a few things, such as, number one, max out your HSA, which is up to $7,000 per family. Number two, max out your Roth 401k or Roth TSP, which, if you have a stable value fund inside your Roth 401k or the G fund, which is earning, you know, roughly 1.3%, that's 1.3% tax-free, which is, again, better than a money market today. And you can put up to $27,000 if you're over 50. Maybe you need to max out your Roth IRA too, which is $7,000 per person for you and your spouse, or max out any permanent life insurance policies, which don't have a limit. So these are just a few strategies where we can put lazy, idle cash to work and put it to work in a tax-free state.
So Andrew, Forbes says that there are several tax mistakes that could end up harming your retirement, aside from assuming your taxes are going to be lower in retirement. One of them is not contributing to a Roth IRA or a 401k. How do we know if we even should consider a Roth IRA?
Well, I think some of the warning signs is if you have a large brokerage account. If you have a large brokerage account, that is money that's taxable. And I just witnessed this today where a client had a large stake in one company, but I told her, I said, it's dead money, quote unquote. What I mean by that is that money can never be sold until she dies, because she would face a huge capital gains. And now we're starting to confuse profits with taxes and which one is more important than the other. When it comes to investing, profits are the goal. So if you have a large brokerage account, that might be a concern or raise flags. Also, look at your overall tax diversification and put pencil to paper. How much of your assets are tax-free? If you don't have 25% of your net worth in tax-free investments, I would want to get a tax plan, a new one.
So another potential tax mistake is taking withdrawals from your accounts in the wrong order. And that even worries me, you know, for my husband and I. How do you help people create a strategy for taking those withdrawals from their retirement accounts?
You're exactly right, Louann. You know, they don't teach us in school which bucket do you pull from first.
Yeah.
But we recommend that you take it from taxable accounts usually, because this allows us a window of opportunity to continue our conversions, our Roth conversions for a client from IRAs to Roth IRAs. So they're taking income from their taxable accounts, which is a tax potentially at the capital gains tax, which is lower, and we're converting IRA assets to Roth IRAs. Because remember this, Louann, when you stop working, you can no longer take those taxable accounts and make them tax-free by putting them into a Roth IRA without earned income. So it's really critical to spend those taxable accounts down first.
Okay, yeah, because my husband always wonders, you know, what to do, but that makes sense. The taxable, take money out of the taxable accounts first. Andrew, you mentioned HSAs, and I don't think people talk about those enough.
I think you're right. I mean, HSAs are a really nice asset because they're triple tax advantaged. And so what I mean by that is you can actually deduct it from your taxes in year one when you make that contribution, but the money inside there grows tax deferred, and you can invest it, surprisingly, in investments like stocks and bonds and mutual funds and ETFs. And then that money can be taken out tax-free for medical expenses. So again, you get a tax deduction, it grows tax deferred, and you can pull that out tax free. And you can do this up until the age that you apply for Medicare. So I would be utilizing an HSA if you have and meet the health insurance deductible. You have to look it up on Google, but the health insurance deductible compared to your health insurance deductible, as long as you're having a high enough health insurance deductible, you can contribute to an HSA. And there's not an earned income limit, and there's not an income cap. So it is a great asset to contribute to before retirement.
Okay, Andrew. So, wow, a lot of great information here. And a lot of listeners might be thinking, I need some more detail on that. And that's what we're offering today. We want to tell them, what is your money saying to you right now? Tell our listeners how they can get a hold of you.
Absolutely. When you call to schedule your discovery visit, I want to share with you what a discovery visit is and what it's not. When you come in, what we won't do is treat it like a dentist visit where we told you, man, you haven't flossed for 10 years. And we talk about all the bad financial mistakes you've made over the last two decades. We won't lock the door behind you and try to sell you the annuity of the week, the stock of the week, the REIT of the week. No, instead, what we'll do is we'll sit down for 1 hour to answer whatever questions that you have. And then we'll look at a two-page questionnaire that you've completed beforehand, and I'll try to find three or four things that you can improve on so that you can walk out of that visit knowing that there's three or four things that you can actually take action on that would improve your retirement odds and ability to sleep well at night. Because that's our goal at Swan Capital, to help families that are going to retire to sleep well at night and have confidence going into their retirement. So give us a call at 1-800-848-8768. That's 1-800-848-8768.